Students, welcome back to the video lecture session on dry circuits for stepper motors. This bit is falls under module 5. Okay, it is continuation of last class. Here, this is figure shows the drive circuit requirement. Okay. So how it is connected and what are these figures, I will explain one by one. Let us first have a glance over the circuit elements, which are this. Okay, so here the input voltage and phase is connected through one switch, and one diode is connected anti-parallel with I phase. Okay, so dry circuits for stepper motor is usually driven from a low voltage DC source. When a phase is to be energized, the DC source is connected to the phase by a semiconductor switch. When you are going to connect, we are turning on this semiconductor switch. Yes, the phase current builds up at the rate decided by the phase windings, electrical time constant. When the phase is to be de-energized, switch is turned off, which transfer the current to freewheeling diode DF. Okay, I will show you here. So what it will be happens when switch is turned on, the current it will be raised, I phase it will be flows, and when the switch is turned off, what it will be happens, it is de-energizes. Okay, the phase is de-energized, which transfer the current to freewheeling diode, and current it will be flows through the freewheeling diode. The current drops to zero again at the rate decided by the time constant of the phase winding. Motor torque, which is function of a IPH, that is a phase current, builds up and decay in the same manner. Okay, this it will be repeated. Now, in order to maximum torque capability of a step motor, what it will be happens, the drive circuit for stepper motor should be such that the current builds up and decay as fast as possible. So it should be decay, means it should be the current switch is turned off. The current which it will be flows here through the freewheeling, it should be decay to the zero, so that we can go for next. Again, we have to start the switch. Okay, so dry circuit for ideally it will be what it is, that this it will be shown here, dotted lines. Okay, this is special important when high stepping rates are required, as demonstrated in figure 8.9c. here you can see what it is there. It will be very important. Okay, so this is the idle case where it will be shown in dotted, but actually we will get in this. Okay, the dry circuit for stepper motors are designed to incorporate these requirements. Okay, it means what, when it will be turned on, the current it will be goes to the increases. I will show once again this, what it will be happens, the current switch is turned on, switch, semiconducting switch, okay, that it will be turned on, current it will be rises. Okay, when it is turned off, current it will be goes to the zero, current it will be freewheels through the diode, and it will be goes to the decays to the zero, and again it will be switch is turned on, the cycle will be repeated. Okay, this is the requirement of dry circuit. Have one discussion about unipolar drive for variable reluctance motor. In case of variable reluctance motor, phase currents need only be switched on or off, and the current polarity does not matter. Okay, unipolar drive, which is capable of supplying current only in one direction, as name it's indicates, okay, current only in one direction sufficient. A simple unipolar drive circuit suitable for low power two phase variable reluctance motor is shown here. I will show you next, it is there. Okay. See here, figure, just what are the elements are there here. Similarly, earlier it is input voltage VD is applied, phase A, okay, one switch, okay, freewheeling diode, one RF resistance, RE resistance. Okay, When switch S1 is closed, phase A winding is connected. Now I will explain how it will be works. Okay. When switch S1 is closed, phase A winding is connected to the DC source. When it is closed, so what it will be happens, the phase winding is connected to the supply voltage VD, okay, and phase current builds up. When it is opened, current will flow through. When it is opened, as shown in the figure, now what it is there, okay, it is opened. The phase current decays in the freewheeling path consisting of phase A, and it will be goes to the where DF, RF, okay, and it will be coming back to the here. Okay, the external resistance RE, okay, this is the external resistance RE, reduces the electrical time constant, thereby speeding up the current buildup. Value of external resistance RE, there are two resistance, external resistance and the feedback, along with feedback, one resistance in series, it is connected with the diode. Okay, now the value of RE is chosen to the fix the value of the electrical time constant, and then the source voltage VD is chosen to produce the rated current IR in the phase winding. So there is a one relation they are using here. We'll show you how they are going to select the value of RE. Okay, I hope this is clear how it will be works. When the semiconducting switch is turned on, I will conclude here, it is turned on, then VD is connected and current it will be built up through this one RE, and phase A1 will be get energized. When switch S1 is turned off, then the current, whatever the it will be stored in this inductance, what it will be happens, or the energy stored in the inductance, which it will be freewheels through this DF, RF and this RE, like that it will be freewheels. Okay, both the case it is clear. And as I discussed, the value of RE and RP, it will be has one relation here, one equation I will show you. This equations they are using to choose the values. Okay, here RE plus RP. RP is nothing but phase winding resistance. Okay, that phase winding resistance means, I will show you. Here, this phase has inductance, but it has its own resistance. So that resistance is considered as here phase winding resistance. And there few points I will discuss here. Go to slide. Okay, when RP is the phase winding resistance, during on period of the switch, phase current also flows through the external resistance RE, causing major proportion of the energy drawn from the source to be dissipated in RE. So here, if you are looking to this figure, RE is connected in series with the phase winding A. So what it will be happens, the current, what it will be draws, it will be flowing through this resistance. Okay, which resistance? It is RE resistance. Due to this, what it will be happens, it causing major proportion of the energy drawn from the source to be dissipated in the form of heat. It is nothing but the current, what it will be flows here, I square R loss, it will be take place here. Okay, further, the energy stored in the phase winding inductance during the on period of the switch is also dissipated in freewheeling circuits resistance when the switch is turned off. So what it will be happens, during the switch is turned off, the here also energy, it will be dissipated in the form of heat. Okay, because of this energy losses, the unipolar circuit is highly inefficient. I repeat here, because due to the energy losses, it will be take place in the RE and RF during the on state and during the off state of the resistance, the energy which it will be dissipated in the form of heat. Hence, these circuit whose circuit it is unipolar. Okay, unipolar circuit is highly inefficient and therefore is suitable only for low power drive circuits for stepper motor. It uses chopper principle. Okay, so an efficient unipolar drive circuit capable of providing fast current buildup and decay. So for such cases, we are going for another one figure. I hope this is clear, because power loss it will be take place to avoid this one. Hence, it is limited to the lower power applications. Okay. Here the another one figure I'm going to discuss. Okay, unipolar drive circuit capable of providing fast current buildup. Okay, it uses chopper principle. Chopper is nothing but it's a simple principle is called fixed DC to the variable DC. Okay, as you have studied in the power electronics. Okay, what it is, chopper principle is nothing but the fixed DC. We are getting the variable DC. Each other phase will employ a similar circuit. The DC source voltage can now be much larger than in the drive circuit for stepper motor. Okay, what earlier I have discussed, this has much larger, means the DC source voltage can now be much larger than in the drive circuit. Okay, for earlier what I discussed. Now, let us have a discussion about the working. To energize the phase, the semiconductor switch S1 and S2 are closed. So to turn on the phase winding, we are turning on the S1 and S2. What it will be happens, current it will be flows through like this. Okay. This connects phase winding to the DC source voltage. It will be connect to the phase winding is connected to the DC voltage source. Okay. And phase current IPH builds up fast. Quickly it will be builds up. There is no resistance are here used. If you are comparing with the previous circuit, there we are used two resistance. Okay, one is feedback side and another one is in series with the phase. Okay, so here what it is, it we are not using any resistance. So hence the current which it will be instantly it will be build up. Okay, when it crosses the rated current IR, so this is one figure it is used here. Okay, here you can see this figure. When it will be reaches to the crosses to the IR, okay, when it crosses the rated current IR by a prescribed amount, S1 is switched off, the phase current freewheels through S2 and D2 and decreases below IR. Okay, when it will be reaches to the IR, so IR is here. What it will be happens, the switch S1 is turned off. I will show you here. Okay. So here, S1 and S2 are closed. I will take pen here. Just a moment. S1 and S2 are closed and it will be reaches to the IR, then S1 is switched off, the phase current freewheels through S2 and D2. So what it will be happens, freewheeling it will be take place S2 and D2. Okay, I repeat here, when the S1 is switched off, when you are switched off S1, just I will conclude once again here. Please concentrate. Once again, I will repeat here. When S1 and S2 are closed, okay, at any T0, the current it will be flows through this path, okay. Next, when the current it will be builds to the IR, just now I have shown the graph IR, S1 is turned off. So what it will be happens, the current it will be freewheel through the S2 and D2. I hope it is clear. Okay, this connects the phase winding to the DC source voltage VD and phase current IPH builds up fast. When it crosses the rated IR by the prescribed amount S1, switch is off, the phase current is freewheels through the S2 and D2 and decrease below IR. Okay, after fixed interval of S1 is turned on, again S1 is turned on. Okay, so phase current IPH increases. Then when it exceeds the rated current IR prescribed amount, S1 is turned off. Thus, alternately turning the switch S1 on and off, the phase current value is maintained to be a nearly IR. Okay, this is the basic principle which it will be used by using the switching turning on and off. And further, if you are turning off the both the this one, the energy whatever it will be stored, that it will be feeding back to the VD. This D1 and D2 it will be conducts. If when the switch S1 and S2 are turned off, here I think it is shown here. Okay, no problem. Here only current waveforms are shown. You can see here, here it is there. So this figure, please concentrate here. When both the switch S1 and S2 are turned off, here minus VD it will be shown, right? So the voltage, what it will be there, that it will be feeding back to the supply. D1 and D2 it will be conducts. Okay, this I explained. Okay, next one is the bipolar drive for permanent magnet and hybrid motors. This bit I will discuss in next video lecture. Okay, thank you.